Balance of payments, measures to control disequilibrium in the balance of payment. Question: how can the government correct an adverse balance of payment through the following measures? 1. Export promotion. 2. Import control. It is a 3-mark question appeared in 2012 ISE board examination. Similar question appeared in 2017 carrying 6 marks. Explain 4 measures to correct disequilibrium in the balance of payment. Answer. Since the answer to the first question is partly covered in the answer to the second question, I shall straightaway give the answer to the second question. The following are the measures to correct disequilibrium in the balance of payments. 1. Depreciation. A fall in the external value of the home currency brought out by market forces against a few specific currencies with which it has adverse balance is called depreciation. After depreciation, the home currency becomes cheap. With the result, the products will become cheap. The prices of its products will become more attractive for other countries to buy. It can export more. The depreciation at the same time makes import costlier and it will import less. Thus, depreciation will correct deficit in the balance of payments. 2. Devaluation. A reduction in the external value of the home currency brought out by passing an official edict by the government is called devaluation. After this, the home currency becomes cheap in the international market. The products also become cheap and highly competitive. This will boost export of the home country. After devaluation, the value of foreign currencies will increase. This will discourage the importers. More exports and less imports will bring equilibrium in the balance of payments. 3. Import restriction. Import restriction takes 2 forms, quota and tariff. Quota can be fixed in 2 ways. The government can fix the maximum quantity for the importers. The importers are at liberty to import within the limit. They are not permitted to exceed the limit. Again, quota can be fixed in terms of foreign exchange. In this case, government will fix the maximum limit of foreign exchange for each importer. The importers can use only that amount of foreign exchange allotted to them. Imposing tariff on the imports is yet another method of restricting imports. When a tariff is imposed, the price of the imported item will increase. It will discourage the domestic buyer. Thus, by discouraging the home buyers from buying imported goods, government tries to restrict import. Of the 2 methods, efficiency of quota is very significant in restricting import. 4. Export promotion measures. The home country can adopt export promotion measures to correct disequilibrium in the balance of payments. It can adopt the following methods to boost export. 1. It can reduce the export duty and offer incentives to the exporters. 2. It can offer subsidy to the exporters. 3. It can offer quality control facility, provide market information, and arrange for exhibition come sale in the international market for the export good manufacturers. 4. It can offer tax concession or give tax holidays to export-oriented industries. 5. It can provide financial assistance at a cheap interest rate to export good industries. 6. It can promote tourism. All the above measures will augment the inflow of foreign exchange into the country and bring about equilibrium in the balance of payments. We shall meet again shortly.